Hey, what's up, everybody? Adobe Masters here, and today I'm gonna be showing you how to enhance your night footage in Adobe Premiere Pro. So basically what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be adding sort of an ambient light to the scene. So you see right here is the before of the effect, and it's not a bad shot at all. It's actually very well exposed. It's got some very interesting detail going on with it, and the lights are captured quite nicely. But what we want to do is we want to make it feel a little bit more like a night scene. And to do that, what we're going to do is we're actually going to add this little bit of ambience to it. So this is a before, and then it kind of comes over here into the after. And you see there wasn't a very big change here, but I feel it makes it feel a whole lot more like a standard representation of a night city. So you have the before over here, which is, like I said, very typical night, but you have this one, and I really feel like this gives it a little bit extra character. So that's what we're gonna be doing today. Let's get started. First thing you need to do is just find a piece of night footage that you want to do this for. I just have this piece that I got off of videos.pexels.com, just for some royalty-free stuff. And you can see that's just a time-lapse of a night shot right here. What we wanna do is we wanna go and add an adjustment layer to it. So we're gonna go into the bottom right here. We're gonna click on adjustment layer, click okay. And then we wanna drag that adjustment layer onto here and then extend it for the entire clip. Now, what we wanna do is go over into the effects, and we wanna search for an effect called Find Edges. So it's under Video Effects, Stylize, and then Find Edges. We wanna drag and drop that onto the adjustment layer like so. We then want to invert the effect right here. So here, it's gonna basically find all the edges and it's gonna make them black. What we wanna do is we wanna select the edges and we want to make them white. And then now, if we go up into the screen mode, what you'll see is it's going to take all that black and it's going to screen it into the background. So now we have the detail from the bottom shot and then just the lights basically selected from the top shot. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to actually stylize this just a little bit. So let's go ahead and change the color. Easiest way to do that is to actually go into your effects, search for an effect called tint, and then drag that onto your adjustment layer. It's right here under video effects color correction, drag tint on here. And then now, if you remember, if we undo this back to the normal here, that it is just black. So the black was screened and everything else was white. And so now what we can do is we can map that white to something. So if we click map white to, we can drag and just basically pick any color we want. The other one I picked red, we can give it a sort of a different feel, maybe like a deep purple right here. Or you could do red, blue, green. There's a whole bunch of different colors you can go with. So now that we hit the purple, let's re-add the screen. Well, re-add the invert, and now you can see that all the purple is, we've basically taken the edges and we've turned them purple. And then now when we screen it, we put that purple onto the shot. Now, right now it's a little bit intense, so we need to do a couple of things to sort of clean up this. First thing we need to do is we need to go ahead and we need to blend this with the original just a little bit. This is gonna help preserve some of that underlying detail. I like to go maybe about 10 or 15% right here. Nothing too big, but it's just gonna sort of preserve a little detail. Next thing we wanna do is we actually wanna go down here and we wanna search for blur. We wanna go and look for, under blur and sharpen, we wanna look for the camera blur. You can really use any blur. Gaussian blur is good. If you want a really stylized effect, you can use directional blur. That kind of gives a fun, like if I drag that one on really quick, you can see it gives a fun like direction sort of to it. You can make it look a little bit, you know, sort of, if you play it right here, it looks very, very stylized this way. But I'm just gonna go with the camera blur on this. And what you can see now is it actually has taken that light that we basically created from grabbing it from the scene, and now we've spread it out, we've made it ambient. And so now already it's looking a little bit more lively, but this is still pretty intense. So we're gonna take the opacity, and we're gonna lower that down. Let's start it off at zero and sort of bring it up. And now we're basically just adding a little bit of light to the scene. We can lower the blur a little bit more. If you go to zero, it looks very like sharp, and you don't want that. You want it to be a little bit blurred so that, again, we're creating that ambience to it. So right about there, and then maybe like 83% on the ambience there, and let's take a look at that right now. And that's looking pretty good. That looks, it gives it definitely a sort of different feel to the footage. For example, if we turn this off and on, you can see there's a whole different feel. It feels a whole lot more, you know, fun and lively, nightlife sort of stuff. Now we can do one more thing. If we hold the Alt key and drag this up, what we're doing is essentially making a copy of it. Now what we wanna do is we want to go into the camera blur, and we wanna go ahead and delete the camera blur off of it, And then we want to go into the tint and we want to choose a different color, something that accents it, maybe like an orange, something that's, you know, sort of different than this color. We want to apply that and then we want to lower the opacity down a ton. So this is without it at all. And let's bring it up just a little bit. And what are we doing here? It's a very subtle change, but we're kind of adding a second dimension to this. So instead of it just going straight purple, we're adding this sort of offset to it as well, a secondary scene, a color in the scene. This works really well when you're trying to choose colors in the scene. So for example, the purples and the oranges work pretty well in the scene because there's a lot of red signs and these sort of orange streetlights. And then this red up here. So it all sort of works. Because if we tried to do blue here, it would make it look a little unnatural because there isn't very many blue signs. But we add that purple in there, it grabs all that reds and it makes it look a little more realistic. However, there was still a lot of yellow in the scene. So when we add the orange and the yellow back in, it just adds a little extra detail and it makes it look, again, just slightly more realistic and sort of more in tune with the scene. And we can, of course, keep messing around with these things. Maybe if we blended it with the original just a touch more, maybe that would make it look better, worse. Just sort of go around with this. But overall, that is the effect. That is what we've created right here. Let's go, let's drag these right to here so we can sort of see a before and after. So you can see before it looked, you know, pretty just standard. But after this, we've kind of enhanced it. We've made it look a little bit more like a lively night scene. We've given it that little bit of ambience that makes it look kind of neat. And if you don't want to go with a color, you can also just stick with the white on here as well. That's perfectly fine. So for example, if you didn't want to be this stylistic, you could go with the white here and back this off. You need to back it off a little bit more right down here and blend it with the original some more. And you could sort of go with almost like a New York City at night shot is what this kind of reminds me of. But overall, you can sort of control this however you want to control this. And you can add the different layers and aspects to it. But that is how you create or you enhance night footage. I love doing this sort of effect. It really does just make it sort of your style and make it fit whatever mood and feeling that you want it to fit. Thanks everyone for joining me. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and throw them in the comment section below or on our website at adobemasters.net. If you want to see more videos similar to this one, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I make a video every other day on Adobe-related products. And until next time, guys, see ya.